that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
Rodgers throw into the hands of Cobb. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Rodgers now on first down. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And the Falcons are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. They're going to start to drive here on the ground with Patterson. And some space here. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 47 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now 3rd down coming up. Here's Ryan. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1. They're going on 4th down. It's Ryan. Oh, he's got his tight end pitch complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up, because defensively, you work on 4th down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. Now Ryan on 1st down. And it's intercepted. He's trying to get it to Ridley. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And the Packers will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Here's Jones again on 2nd down. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Now Rodgers. Flushed out right. This is Cobb with a catch right side. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
The play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Got a man open. It's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams there to make the grab. And the Packers are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. So now Rodgers will lead the Packers up to go for two. Rodgers will throw for it. And they're going to get the two-point conversion, caught in the end zone, and that cuts the lead a bit further. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Fielded right around the 8. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's got his pass-catching tight end. That's Pitts. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
They'll run on first down. Patterson. Preston Smith there on the stop. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. The Falcons on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. Ryan. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's got some space here. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
On first down, it's Patterson. He takes this down to about the 12 for a gain of 3. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover, because one more score, and this game's over.
And here he'll get it down to the 7. It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's 3rd down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And the Falcons are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
Davis, and he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Mike Davis, fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Ku able to connect on the extra point, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Touchdown. Here's Ku to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And the Falcons are going to take over once again.